He really was the winner of American Idol, except he said Jesus too many times, so he couldn't possibly win. Anyway.
The winner in our heart.
What's up? We are Adam and Ashleigh Reeker.
Hi.
We hail from Omaha, Nebraska, where it's really cold outside tonight, you guys.
It's like, very cold. Yeah.
Should I open up the window?
No, please don't do that.
We can shiver so they like have a visual of how cold it is here.
Don't do that, please.
Okay.
Anyway. Well, we just want to welcome you to Monday nights. We're kicking off the week after a long Thanksgiving weekend. We had a
brought the microphone in for quite some time. Can everyone hear us? Can everyone hear us okay?
Guys, this is great. We bought this mic. We actually should probably use this. We bought this mic for shooting videos.
It doesn't even need to be plugged in.
Because the sound quality is so much better when you have a mic, and we haven't used it ever.
But when you're on our Monday night webinar on the Conference Center software, you don't even need one of these. That's how good it is.
Exactly.
So.
We are kicking off tonight. And for those of you who don't know us, we introduce ourselves. We just want to welcome you. If this is your first time checking out this webinar, hey, hi, hello.
Hey.
You made it to the right spot.
They did.
It's pretty cool that we're given the responsibility, the great responsibility to come here and talk to all of you. And we like to run our webinars a little differently. And honestly, every leader that runs webinars Monday through Thursday, everyone has their own style, but we really all teach from the same thread. But Adam and I get to talk about mindset and something that we're very passionate about, which is called duplication. And I'm not talking about 2 times 2 equals 4. But tonight,
because that would be multiplication.
Oh my gosh. Oh.
All right, I'm taking over the rest of the webinar. Oh, who's really serious about your business?
There are no words sometimes. Wow. All right, so please don't judge.
Okay, duplication, replication, multiplication. You guys want to multiply your business. I mean, that's what I would assume.
Yeah, that's true. Anyway, I was going somewhere with that. Yeah, we get to talk about that. We love it. It's the best. No, so if you had an opportunity, if you got Joel's email, Joel typically will send out a just like a blast to everybody, inviting them out to these webinars. Because truly, plugging into these types of things, when we have people who like just get started, and we tag up with everybody who gets started, or we just
sure
give
do.
Them the opportunity to. You have people that sometimes decide not to take action, or they ignore their email because they just signed up for an online business, and why would you read your email if you do that? And then, like, a couple weeks later, they're, like, throwing up the white flag, like, I don't know what to do, and I don't know what to blah, blah, blah. I'm like, well, did you plug in? Because there's a webinar that runs every night, Monday through Thursday, and it's a great opportunity to get plugged in.
Well, who else does webinars during the week?
Our personal coach and mentor, Daniel Kump, does them Tuesday evenings, same bat time, same bat channel, i.e.
True.
The same conference room on Tuesday evenings.
Same link you click tonight, just click it again tomorrow night, and you can see our personal coach. He's helped us become very successful.
Earned over $150,000 with this company, is a diamond in this organization, stays home full time. And then on Wednesday nights, John and Richard Weberg, the dynamic father-son duo from up north, Also, diamonds in this company are going to help you get your mind right and just give you some motivation.
And Don and Janet Legere.
And then on Thursday nights, our Canadian friends from way up north.
They're so cool.
At 7:30
you guys gotta plug in.
PM Central Time. Yeah, Don and Janet Legere. And Janet walks you through literally how to set up your entire system.
Sometimes she goes live during the day too. Mm-hmm. Like, there's, if you guys want to plug in, you can always plug in.
Yes.
I might turn my head around backwards tonight. We're going to get into some very cool stuff tonight.
I'm excited.
And here's what I want everybody to know. I'm just going to set some, well, because it's like, you can only see half of my head here. And there's like another half of my head right now. Like, you look pretty all the time. Like, half of my head just looks goofy. So we just want, like, there's another half of my ugly head.
But on the real though, on the real though. So Teresia, I got this in the chat.
Oh, cool. Okay, guys. So we are going to talk about some stuff that, you know, honestly, we'll be brutally honest. If you saw the email and you plugged in this webinar tonight, you probably like saw the tagline, we're just going to get real tonight. Well, we pretty much tend to get real every Monday night. And the thing that I have noticed and I've seen throughout over a decade in this industry, whether it be online or offline, the people that I can get real with that receive it, they grow. Okay. Now, if you want me to pat you on the back and put the little kid gloves on and tell you what you want to hear, I don't know how successful you're going to be. I understand we live, and I'm just going to say, I don't even care if 50 people hop off this webinar right now. We live in a time in this country, in this world, where people need to get tough. Okay? And the reason I want to tell you, all of you, that, first and foremost, is because we've had to get tough in our life. And just let me give you just a little bit of a tidbit. It works. Tough people win, okay? You ever heard the saying, tough times don't last, tough people do? Pretty much, all right? And so Ashley and I are coming to you from our home office tonight. Our very first, this is our starter home, which was custom built. We came from a 500 square foot apartment. We are college dropouts. We used to be so very, very poor. So if you're checking this out for the first time and you're saying, shoot, I just want to be able to pay my next bill, or shoot, I really wish I was further along in my life, I'm here to give you permission to just let you know you can do that.
Yeah.
But you're going to have to do some things differently than you've done them in the past. And the most important thing that we can give you, because I'll never tell someone to do something that I haven't already done, you got to fix your brain and you got to fix your heart. Okay. And so if I'm talking about fixing someone's brain, the first thing I want to do, I want to be brutally honest with them. Now, here's what sometimes in this industry, online or offline, I don't care, makes me mad. It's like the nicest way I can say it makes me mad. Okay. Someone says, anybody can do this thing, or you're not living the life that you deserve. Go make what you're worth. Okay. So I'm going to start this webinar out right now. I don't think it'll get any more brutally honest than this. You're already living the life you deserve. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. You are already living the life that you deserve. Okay. If you deserve more, you would have more. Why? Because if you deserve more, you would have done more. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, I'm not talking about believing the lies of the world, because I will be also very, very bold about this statement. The world's lying to you. Everybody says, go to high school, you know, go to school, whatever. Get good grades so you can get into a good college. Go to college. Spend like $100,000. Get really good grades so you can get a good job. How is that going? How is that going? Or is it not going?
Yeah.
Okay. So everybody can hate me. You can just send me a hate email after this, but I'm going to tell you, you believed a lie. You believed a lie, and you believed a lie, and that there's a better way. Because here's the thing. Going to school, going to work, all of that is for what? It's so you can make money, right? We want to make some money. Okay, but what you're doing a lot of times in a job is you're making money for somebody else, and I hate to be this honest with you, but you probably believed a lie. Unless you're the owner of a company, you are replaceable. And so the title of this webinar tonight was You Don't Matter. Okay? And so we're going to get into this. And like I said, if you hate me after this, I don't care. At least I told you the truth. You don't matter. You don't matter unless you matter. Okay? Anybody ever? Go ahead.
Sorry. Hang tight with us, because what we're saying,
or you can quit right now. I don't care either way.
But what we're saying to you means something, and it doesn't mean what you think it might mean.
No, it doesn't. I opened us up and said, I'm going to love on you. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to be honest with you because I love you enough to tell you the truth, honestly. And we have one of the most amazing guests coming on that we've ever brought on. GMC will be laying out 15,000 workers and closing 5 plants. I saw that today, Jason. I saw that today.
Wow.
Anyway, so here's what happened. So I said, well, you don't matter unless you matter, right?
Okay.
Everybody in their life, everybody's probably, well, maybe not everybody. You ever seen the movie Pinocchio? Like he's like one of these things where, what's that guy's name?
Which one?
Like the old man that
Geppetto,
right? And he's got Pinocchio and he's like a puppet on a string doing whatever. Geppetto's like the man. Geppetto's like your boss. Geppetto's like the world lying to you. And Pinocchio's like, I want to be a real boy. But every time he says that, he's just a liar, so his nose is growing. If you want to be a real boy, you got to get real with yourself. Same thing. If you want to be a real business owner or a real business builder, your nose better not grow when you tell me you're going to do something. Okay, because it's serious and it works. So,
or when you tell yourself you're going to do something.
Lying to yourself is probably the worst part.
Yeah.
But building a business, just so everybody knows, is hard. I mean, it really is. Motivating myself sometimes is hard. Okay, went to school, got a job, I got the promotion. Okay, fine. But when you got, through school, when you got the job, when you got the promotion, is it what you thought it would look like? Okay, maybe it is. It wasn't for me. It wasn't for Ashleigh. And Ashleigh probably has a pretty profound story. We don't need that story to get into tonight. She's been there in the past. Until you learn to work through the hard, that hard will never become familiar for you. Everyone on this webinar tonight, at one point in time, you could not walk. True?
Yeah.
Somebody came out of the womb just sprinting and running and jumping, they could walk. No, you didn't. Everybody on here, at some point in your life, you couldn't even walk. You couldn't roll over. You couldn't eat for yourself. Somebody had to do everything for you. Okay. And so here's what I love about what we do in this industry. We have a whole bunch of people that come on. The sharpest ones are already very successful in something, which wouldn't have been us because we were college dropouts and like restaurant servers. We're doing okay. Because we learned how to make the hard familiar. It wasn't always familiar for you to walk. Pretty familiar today, right? Wasn't always familiar for you, hopefully, like to brush your teeth or whatever. But now it's very familiar to you.
Mm-hmm.
When you signed up for Now Lifestyle, why in the world did you think you were supposed to be able to sprint before you could stand up? Here's why everybody loses online. They expect to know everything. They think because what they did offline in the past, evidently, because that's what college told them probably, or their job or their boss or promotion or whatever, I'm going to be real. They just told me it was supposed to roll in, so the rest of your life's just going to be better, except I'm sorry, bro or sister, you've never built an online business before, so I recommend you zip it, you open these, and you start to learn how to stand on your own then walk on your own. Why? Because the upside in this thing is about a bazillion times bigger than the upside you could ever do in your job, and I don't even care if you're the owner of it. Okay? Boom. Meanest I'm going to be tonight? Meanest I'm going to be tonight? Probably. Here's the thing. The thought that motivated you to reach a goal. So you got through college, right? You just made it all the way through to this point in your life. There was a thought that motivated you, which was your reality. The thought that motivated you is what puts you to probably get to where you are. And then once you get to where you are, is the thought that you had about where you are reality or is it not? Most of the time, ourselves included, when we reach a goal, it's nothing like the picture that we painted in our head that motivated us to get there. Is that wrong? Heck no, because we're better for having. Then we're better because we got there.
Yeah.
Make sense? So when you get there, sometimes it ain't pretty. Sometimes it ain't beautiful. Okay. We make several thousand dollars a month online 9 months after we started online, and it doesn't look the way I thought it was going to look. Let me tell you, I wouldn't take it back for anything. One of the reasons I wouldn't take it back for anything is because of the relationship that we've been able to build. Okay. I know this isn't your typical now lifestyle webinar. I don't care. You'll never get that with us. Okay. But one of the biggest things that you have to do in any area of your life, you get to choose your hard. It's hard working a job. Okay. It's hard building a business. But if you're going to go work a job, I don't care how many promotions you get, it's still going to be hard. You're just not going to make what you're worth. So choose your hard. Choose your hard. Because whether you work a job or you build a business, it's hard. One's going to pay you not enough. One's going to pay you whatever you want it to pay you. Okay? So with that, I've probably been talking for like 6 minutes too long here. So
it's all good.
It's my beautiful bride, Ashley, and she's super nice.
Is that it?
Yeah.
That's all?
That was her introduction this evening.
Oh, we got to work on transitions, babe.
Well,
both of us.
Well,
not
I'm,
just
not,
you.
I'm not perfect.
I'm pretty bad at transitions as well. Speaking of transitions, let's talk about it. So we have a very special guest to bring on tonight, and we called him a heavy hitter. And he's a heavy hitter in our lives.
He's a heavy hitter in my life for sure.
So I want to know, or actually want to tell you, I want to tell you something. I want to be very transparent in this as well. When did we meet Don?
6 months ago, probably.
Six,
7 months ago.
Gentleman was on actually a webinar just like this. And I think either we were getting interviewed by Daniel or it was maybe once we had just started doing these Monday Night Lives. And this gentleman, we talked, we said we're from Omaha, and this guy's like,
this crazy,
I'm
small
from Omaha
world.
Too. And we're like, what? And we came to know and love Donald Leath. And from just from my perspective as a wife, my husband and I are very prayerful people. You know, we believe in the source, you know, Jesus is, he's our risen savior. And if that's not your, cup of tea, that's totally cool. We love all people. That's awesome. But for a long time, we had both prayed for some people in our lives and people that could come in and impact and speak life into us, because we both come from kind of broken homes. Like, you know, I had a mother that's been married 3 times and I love her dearly. And Adam's parents are still married, but not necessarily, you know, the picture of marriage that we would want for our lives. And so we've had to find those influences outside of our biological family. And when we met Donald and his wife, Candy, instantly just knew that these were people that were going to be with us for a long time, whether we were doing business with them or not. Donald became a business partner of ours. And we have just had an incredible journey with him. We got to go down to the event in Texas, and we actually flew down with him. We took the same flights down. And what an amazing friend. And really for us, he's become a trusted advisor. He's someone that we can speak candidly in front of. And, you know, he may not have all of the success that he wants to have online, but Donald has been a very, very well accomplished man in his life. Both just not only in business, like he was a business owner, executive, extremely successful salesman. The guy is relationship driven. He can talk to anyone. I mean, it's absolutely amazing just watching him connect with people. I thought we were good at that. And I saw Donald. I'm like, never mind. You put us to shame.
Hang on. Get me a notepad and a pen, please.
But not only that, he is a man's man. He leads by example. He is an amazing father and husband and friend to us. And we are just so excited to get to share him with you tonight and get to talk about and let him share some of his experience. So we've talked for way too long at this point. We're going to let him hop on. So Donald, if you can go ahead and just hit the talk now button and we'll get you welcomed on here. Yeah, I'm excited to get to share him with you guys tonight.
Oh,
so
man, some people can't see it.
That's all right. She was having some issues. Bam. There he is. Hey, Donald.
Hang on. Let's make this thing.
Do the other one. Here.
Oh, hang on.
Oh, don't do that.
That one right there.
There you go. All right.
Hello, sir. How are you?
So, anyway, I'm doing fine. Where'd you go? I guess they left the webinar. There we go.
All right. Are you there, sir?
We're here. It's okay.
Can you hear us okay?
One second, Tom. One second, sir.
Type that in. We're going to sign this back in.
This is going to be a silent movie. So whatever, if you guys can hear me, where are some of you from? There's old Stanley. Hi, Stan. Hey, Jason. Louisiana. Got some good friends in Baton Rouge. Am I echoing those? Hey. Okay, also have some good friends in Marietta. If I said that correctly, not sure about that. But Little John 68 in Missouri. I'm a Missouri boy originally, born and raised in a little town of Macon, north of Columbia. Alabama, Sweet Home Alabama, love that song. St. Louis used to have the St. Louis Cardinal football and baseball. Of course, they still have baseball, but I don't think they even have a football team anymore. Probably not. New Orleans. All right. Is that all one word, right? New Orleans? Is that how you say that correctly? Great town. Well, I hope the Reekers didn't fall off the big Nebraska map. It's so flat up here, they could fall off. Roll Tide, stay in your case. Yeah, they went back to LA, the Rams did, that's for certain. Yeah. If you guys can hear me, everybody can hear me, throw a one or something in the comments here, would you? So I can know. Let me just go ahead and start talking to you. All right. Cool. All right, we're going to go ahead. I don't know what happened to the Reeker kids, but anyway, Donald Leith here in Omaha, Nebraska, actually a little suburb of Elkhorn. I could probably, if I had a really good arm, throw a rock at the Reeker's house from where we live. So that's a good thing. We are blessed, you know, to have them as our team leaders. Very humbling, their introduction. But I would like to share with you guys just the concept of mindset. You guys are back. I'm ahead with that.
I'm good.
Pretty good back, okay?
Yeah, your audio is breaking up for us. Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to switch to Zoom.
Everybody even know they can hear me. But you want to switch?
Sorry for the tech difficulties.
Other people are paying for the sound.
Good enough.
Hank's going to jump over to Zoom.
Can hear me. I'm just kind of testing out a couple of things just to make sure that this is going live. Yes, we are. Awesome. Cool.
Hey, everyone.
Very, very good. All right. So I'm going to go paste this into what's up, guys. Thanks, Jason and Ulema, for your help on that. Really appreciate it. It's so interesting, you guys, whenever Adam and I personally, when we have an awesome guest on and we start speaking truth, the conference center software just does its, like, it just goes haywire on us. So I'm just posting something in the group here. Cool. So, all right, we are up and live, and let's double check. There is Donald. So Donald, I'm just going to get you queued up here, my friend. So thanks everyone for hanging tight with us. We really appreciate it. I hate technical difficulties. I know we all do. So we really appreciate it. What's up, Donald? I'll let your, looks like your microphone's just getting ready here to pick up. So we'll give it another minute. Maybe for some reason. Donald, for some reason, it's not showing a microphone for you. There we go. Oh, there it is. Hey, Donald.
Hi. Can you hear me?
Are you there?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
My computer was on mute. I was like, oh, no. Awesome. Oh, man. Okay, cool. So, guys, thanks so much for tuning in.
Well, let's get this out of the way.
Oh, that's my bad. I don't know. Something keeps popping up. There we go. All right, cool.
We're going to go ahead and record this because what you guys are about to be a part of is really special. And go ahead and record that right now.
Sweet.
Everybody that comes on to Now Lifestyle within the 3LE team, within anybody's team, or especially with your on Donald Lee's team, you guys are super blessed because you are about to hear from somebody that has a ton of experience in the business world, online and offline. And Ash and I have just been so blessed to be associated with him. And some things that we have been talking about prior to this webinar was being really honest with people that see this, okay? Some people will see it, some people won't. Mm-hmm. But building a business, sometimes it's hard. And I think motivating yourselves a lot of times is kind of hard. And so whether you went to school or you did it the exact same way the world told you to do it, that you're probably finding out isn't working, it's hard. How do I get motivated? Okay. How do I just do what everybody's telling me because they're telling me I'm going to win, but then I'm finding out that they were lying to me for their own gain. And what you'll never find within 3LE team, Now Lifestyle, or on Don Lee's team, he'll never lie to you unless it's, he won't lie to you, period, but he's only going to tell you what to do for your benefit. Okay. And so with that, it's been a great pleasure and honor to know you. You've helped me out a ton personally, and I'm excited to continue our relationship in the future. So I just want everybody to hear from Donald Leith first and foremost, and then we've got some stuff to ask you about.
Okay. Hey, I'm sitting in a little box here. Do you want me, or I'm cool with it? Everything fine?
You're good just the way you are, Don.
Oh, Donald, you can fix that on your end. If you hit either speaker view or gallery, if you hit gallery view up in the top right-hand corner of your Zoom, that should because okay. Everything. Both of us side by side, it's just on your computer that you were up like that.
Okay.
Awesome.
Well, while we were having a little technical difficulties and a few things that were happening, I guess I was thinking a little bit about how the different things in life influence all of us and how we become kind of products of our environment. And we all are, you know, it starts on us from the time we're born. We have all these habits that are kind of set into us by the time we're 7 years old. And when people try to change those, it becomes very, very difficult. And one story that kind of comes to mind, I love this story. I'm a big Zig Ziglar nut, and had the opportunity to be with him many times when he was alive. And anyway, it's on an Easter morning, and so step into the Ziglar household with me for a second. And Zig's in the kitchen, and his wife is in there, and she's sawing the end off the ham. And he looks over at her and he says, "My gosh," he said, "what in the world are you doing? Why are you sawing the end off that ham?" And she said, "Well, Zig, I guess I never really thought about it." She says, my mom always sawed the end off the ham. And so he said, so he goes over, mom is there, of course, and grandma. And so he goes over and asks her. She says, "Well, Zig, nobody's ever asked me that question before." She said, "Gee, I did it because my mother cut the end off the ham." Well, great grandma happened to be there too in the living room. So he goes in the living room and poses the same question to great grandma. And she says, "Well," after she thought about it for a second, she says, "Well, Zig, I cut the end off the ham because my roasting pan was too short." And
that's really awesome.
So sometimes we fall into the same category with things that we're doing in our life because it's just the way that it's always kind of been done. So therefore we want to do it. And what happens is we get this programming that goes on inside of our heads. Because, you know, I grew up in a little town in Missouri and I heard my entire life. And in fact, I had this aspiration. There's nothing back then, gas stations in my hometown, when you pulled in, they vacuumed it out, they cleaned your windshield, they did everything, they gassed it for you, the whole bottle of wax. And it was kind of a cool job to have. And as a kid, I was thinking, well, that'd be a pretty good thing to do, you know, because you grew up in this environment like this. And it was a coal mining community, hardworking people, and so on in that process. But so that became kind of the, you know, all the different things that you're exposed to. But there are so many things that happened in my life that I think added to it. And one I heard many years ago was a fellow was talking about luck. You know, he had this luck and was lucky and so on. And there could even be people that say, "Well, the Reeker kids, they're really lucky. Look what they've done. They've come on in such a short time period and they've just had all this luck, et cetera." And I just want you to know and go on record tonight that there is no such thing as luck. Luck does not exist. Luck is an acronym. And I would tell you, hang on to this one, because luck is labor under controlled knowledge. That's what luck means. That's what it stands for. So, you know, does that mean that someone is fortunate if they win the lottery or whatever? Well, I suppose you could say that. But everybody talks about how luck works. Luck does not function that way in our lives. It's just luck becomes something that other people look at because of the hard work. I mean, I could say, look how lucky the Reekers are. Well, you've been busting your butts, you know, pardon my French, in the whole process of where you're getting to. And so that's that in the whole aspects of all of it that's coming along. Mm-hmm. So you just want to get caught up in the mindset. And you've talked a lot about it, different sessions with mindset and so on. And, you know, and the other day I did some videos and I made a comment. Actually, it's not mine. It's Ray Higdon's comment that you get to keep what you speak.
Yes.
Yep.
You know, and man, that just drove it home. So you get to keep what you speak. And the Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he, you know, and probably not exactly that way, but it's very close to that verbatim. And so this whole process and you say, whether you think you can or whether you think you can't, you're right, you know, and it just goes on and on and on. So what is this all about when we start talking about people that want to quit? Well, I think it's a normal reaction to have ups and downs, you know, in your life and opportunities and things that come along like that. You were talking, Adam, a few weeks ago you made the comment, like you did tonight, about people that going to college and the people that and different jobs and so on. I took that and I checked and I Googled. I want to find out what percent of people are actually working today in the profession of which they were educated in? Well, you're looking at one that isn't, you know. There's old Undertaker Don. I have a degree in mortuary science. We've talked about that. I'll talk a little bit more about that this evening. But so I'm not in that profession. So there's only 27% of the people that have been to college, excluding doctors, lawyers, accountants, and that group, only 27% of those people are still in their educated profession.
Yeah.
They've broken away and done other things. In my hometown, one of my good friends he was a teacher, biology teacher, and he ran the ConAgra plant in my hometown. This is an example.
Wow.
Okay. Now, you can take a little humor and put with that, because I think it's important tonight when we start talking about that you don't matter. I think it's really important to know that you don't matter, but you do really matter. But yet you don't matter.
Yes.
You know, and it becomes a cycle. It just fires around and around and around in the process. But you really do, because it's your decisions that matter. Mm-hmm. It's what makes it all happen.
Yep.
All right. So this is some humor, but you know, you start talking about looking at career changes, et cetera. And I want you to come along with me on this little trip because this is an hysterical journey. Once you decide to leave the funeral business and go into sales. Okay? Now, first of all, your wardrobe is comprised of all black clothing, dark clothing, et cetera. And by the way, the reason you wear dark clothing to funerals is because medieval times, black was to ward off evil spirits. And that always carried forward in a process. At least that's what they told us in school. If that doesn't still apply, well, it doesn't still apply. But the fact of the matter is, when you go and you try to apply for a job, people look at you like you fell out of a well. Like, what is somebody with this kind of education think they can do in terms of sales?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, I've been around a lot of people. I used to sell vacuum cleaners and encyclopedias door to door. Now that is without a doubt the hardest sales job that I ever experienced in my life, where you just start going neighborhood to neighborhood, knocking on doors. I don't know whether that takes gumption or stupidity. It's probably a combination of the two in the process. If you don't know what a canned sales presentation is, a canned sales presentation is one which is memorized to the point that you can stop on a comma and pick up on the next paragraph, back up. It's just part of your innate ability. And so we had these things so well rehearsed, et cetera. And my hardest sale I ever did in my life was selling encyclopedias. Mm-hmm. But one night I was leaving a home and I had sold a set of encyclopedias to this family, and I got a block away from that house. And I said to my, those people can't afford those books. There's no way they can afford those books. It's just crazy. They can't do it. And so I went back to unsell them.
Wow.
Hardest sale I ever did in my life was unselling them. But I got it done. Yeah. And, you know, it was difficult because it became an issue of integrity. Not that I told them anything dishonest. It's just the fact that when you break it down, you can dash so many pennies a day here, put in this little bank and, you know, the whole process. And you can do that convincing and so on. So I'm probably babbling a little bit here, but the whole process is this becomes a mindset. All right. And the key here is that I've lived enough years in my life where I've seen so many different things change and so many different opportunities that came along that people didn't take action on. And because of that, they missed out on a wonderful, wonderful opportunity. And they didn't because they were trying to employ the luck syndrome, or they were trying to hang on to all the negativity that had been pounded into them all their life. You know, you can't do this, and you know, you can't do that, you shouldn't do this, and all these different factors. Instead of being told that spread your wings and soar like an eagle, you can do anything in life you want to do, you can go anywhere you want to be and do anything you want to do if you just believe in yourself and go to work. That's a bigger thing too. Okay. And it's very, very true. And when I heard those words, they became real actually very invigorating for me. But anyway, I was successful in getting through and getting hired by the telephone company in my lifetime. And I ended up with a GTE corporation. And I did that not because of my great astute ability, but because my uncle was working there and he knew some of the right people and he got me an interview.
Mm-hmm.
And so I went to work for the phone company, and we at the phone company at GTE were the largest customer for a company called Executone Communications. And they were based out of Long Island City, New York. And so as a result of that, I was in the sales group and we sold a lot of Executone equipment. We did the product very, very well in the whole process. And so when I'm not doing that, at that time, nobody could buy a phone. You couldn't buy your own phone. And hence I'm talking about another market opportunity here. Okay. I sat and I watched this market. Now I'm fighting against competitively companies that are coming in to sell to our phone company customers. All right. This is new. Nobody's ever experienced this ever before in the telephone industry. It's always like you pay so much a month for this button, so much a month for this light, you know, and they just drove you crazy with all the different rates, et cetera. But this is a result of a very wealthy Texan named Tom Carter, who previously to the year 1968 was a multi-millionaire, and he took on a little company called AT&T with his Carter phone decision, and he beat them. He won. And that started the industry today that we all hold in our hands and everything else. Tom Carter is the guy who started that whole thing. One guy brought down AT&T, and he did that. Did he do that because he had a negative mindset? Did he do that because, no, he did it because he was sold out. He was so convinced with what he was doing that he sold out. He was almost broke when he finished, but he passed as a mega multimillionaire in the process. In our industry, the most coveted thing you could get was the Tom Carter Award.
That's awesome.
My whole point, certainly that's on a huge scale, but just bring it down now into your own backyard. Bring it down to your own dining room table. It's the same mentality.
Yep.
It's the same spark can start a little fire or it can burn down California. Okay? We all witnessed that, right? Yep. And it can fire your engine and you can go after what you want. It's abandoning all the negativity stuff. It's like getting up and just kind of shaking it off, getting that crust off and say, you know, I've listened to all this stuff long enough. I know I can do it. And you go after it. So I'm just running on here. I don't know what you had questions or anything you had for me, but I see this so much that there are people that have so much opportunity. And do I have any fears in my life? Yeah, I have a fear. I have a fear of going to my grave, not playing my music.
Amen.
People say it all the time. Well, why don't you just not do? Why don't you just quit? Why don't you do that? And I said, because I'm having too much fun.
Yeah.
No, and besides that, my bride of 30 years, Candy, she's 11 years younger. She's not ready to quit. And she's always said, go do something. Well, after we sold the business, I started a consulting company. Mm-hmm. I had 54 employees in the company. And so now there's just me in the company.
Yeah.
But I do consulting work. And like today, I mean, I probably 8 hours of my day today was spent on helping some different companies I'm working with some different issues and whatever, because you don't know the things that you don't necessarily know. You know, all these different perspectives that we have. We all go out and we have different learning experiences and we bring them together and we start firing off of each other. And guess what? We got power in that process of doing it when people are open-minded. Okay. And so what is one of the greatest strengths, for example, that exist in Now Lifestyle that even Amazon doesn't have, Walmart doesn't have, any other mega company? What do they not have that Now Lifestyle can just brutalize them with? What do they not have? They don't have relationships. They don't have relationships. You put our group together with relationships and firing off of each other and exchanging ideas and helping each other, it's unstoppable.
Yeah.
It's unstoppable. You can't get that anywhere else. Here, there's just, that's one of the primary reasons that I came to Now Lifestyle was after I went to Cabo and met with Joel and got to meet him and see his heart. Like I said, when we were in Texas, I was toast. I was done with it. But when I met him and I met the other people, the other leaders, many of them are just a group that's phenomenal. And you guys came in right in as leaders, meld right into the whole process. And there's so much that I've learned from all the different leaders in this group. It's just amazing. So the fact of the matter is that in the online world, let me back up for a second and just run you a little quick comparison. I'm sorry just to be going on here.
No.
The thing that happened here is you kickstarted an old salesman, so he's going to dump on you.
Yes, good.
From this standpoint, today when I hear people, you know, they talk about, wow, $50 a month to be in Now Lifestyle, and then you have to go all in and that's $500. Look, these are real dollars. I get it. They are real dollars. I mean, I can look back at my career and you know the old saying, if it costs a nickel to do what, you'd have to do something else, right? And I won't get into all the details. And if you don't know what that means, I'll talk to you offline. but the process is you have an opportunity here in Now Lifestyle to make phenomenal dollars with a very minimal investment. Now, just give me a, let me give you a little comparison. Okay, I'll back up to when I bought the company. Actually, I was with the company. I'd been there a couple of years. The owner, 56 years old, had a heart attack and died one weekend. I was literally leaving. AT&T had offered me a job. I hadn't turned my letter of resignation in yet. And so I felt obligated to stick around to help the family, help the staff, et cetera. They wanted to put the company up for sale, which, okay, understood that. And I agreed with that. And there were like 12 different groups that wanted to buy the company. And I was not one of them. I was just trying to run things along with it. I was living over in Iowa at the time, and I had a very good friend who was the banker there where I banked. And I walked in Wendy one day, and he said, "Hey, how's it going to that company? Who's, you know, anybody buy it yet or whatever?" I said, "Oh, no." I said, "There's several people looking, but, you know, nothing's really happened with it." He said, "Well, you got any numbers? Let's take a look at it." And I says, "What are you talking about?" And I'll leave his name out of it because I'll protect him here. But he said, "Well, let's take a look at it." He said, maybe it's something we should buy. And I said, "What do you mean we?" I said, I just left the phone company. I said, "I don't have the money to buy a company like that," and whatever. Anyway, I went out to the car, and I had records there and performers and things, financials, et cetera. And he looked at it, and he put everything together. And here's a key word that you've never heard, joining Now Lifestyle. He said, "Would you be willing to sign a personal guarantee?" Now, okay, let me translate that. Would you be willing to sign this piece of document that says, "I get everything in your life that you own now and forevermore if this baby tanks"? Okay. Your home, everything you have. Are you willing to sign a personal guarantee? And I said, "Why? What I'd suddenly decide of that?" He said, "Well, if you'll do that," he says, "let's buy this sucker." I said, "What's that mean?" He says, "I'll front the money." He says, "I know you." He says, you'll take care of it." I said, "I've never signed a personal guarantee." And he said, "You should do this." Well, I did. Wow. And we paid it off in 3 years.
Oh, mic drop.
Yeah. And why was that? Well, because we got the right time. The timing was right. Okay. It was literally, and we joked about this, but and I want to bring that timing around to where we are today with Now Lifestyle. The timing was Tom Carter had exploded the marketplace. Everybody was looking at it. Businesses at that time, we spent most of our time convincing businesses that it was legal to buy a phone system. I'm in the phone company. Arrest me. I'll go to jail.
That's amazing.
No, it's okay. It's okay. And believe me, the people that didn't understand the industry at all were the phone companies. Mm-hmm. I mean, they had never had to operate where they, through their own managerial skills, made profit. They are guaranteed a guaranteed rate of return based upon investment and bottom line profits. And they didn't, and never was there incompetence or waste involved in that consideration. It was just always how these numbers work out. And I mean, I wasn't in the accounting group, but I know when rate increases came, that's how they happen. Okay. So it's kind of hard to compete in that particular arena. But the fact of the matter is, it was a window. Okay. Beautiful timed window to get into it. I got into it. They broke up in 84, they broke up AT&T and created the five Bell operating companies called RBOX, Regional Bell Operating Companies, of which one was US West that we had here for years. And I think, if I remember correctly, don't hold me to this, but I think one of them that made it was Verizon. The ones who went out and got business people and put them in charge and not phone company employees made it. The ones who ran it like government, they didn't make it.
Yep.
Okay. Very plain and simple. All right. So the timing was awesome. When they broke them up, I went from four competitors to 44 competitors.
Wow.
In 1 year. Okay. We stuck it out. At the end of 2 years, we were back down to three or four or five competitors. Yeah. In and out of business, et cetera. Okay. So the point of matter is another window. Then we go back and stop for a second and think about the dot-com era, how all that happened. All right. Yeah. And then here came the cell phones. Okay. I always had a phone in my car because I had a big territory to cover when I was here. Mm-hmm. I had a rotary dial. It wasn't a cell phone. It was called a mobile phone.
Yes.
Okay. And that's because maybe it was mobile. I mean, you could call China from it, but yeah, it was mobile. And here's a little point of trivia for you. On a rotary dial phone, there's some things on the Facebook not recently. We had some millennials trying to dial a rotary phone. I don't know if you saw that or not.
It's pretty good.
It was hysterical.
Yep.
On a rotary dial phone, the number actually dials on the return trip. You take your finger around to the guard and let it go of it. And because you don't leave it in, now you'll misdial. Okay. Well, then from there, we went to push button dial. And then there was a big rumor later on that we're going to have personal communication services, which today we call cell phones. My whole point here is another window. And timing, time to move, all right? A friend of mine had a paging company here in town where he rented pagers. He'd go down and get them from the phone company, rent them from them, go out and sub-rent them to people. Anyway, it was insane business. He sold it to US West for $15 million, moved to Florida, and opened a golf course. Okay? They turn around and ran the business.
Wow.
Okay? So when then here comes cell phone. I'm not to dwell, but it's a window. So I got to come right back now to now lifestyle and say, look at all the companies that haven't made it online business. Look at the reputation that's out there in the business world today. What stands out today? Okay. What has longevity? What has solid shelf and digital products, the proper mixture of those? What has management that's hands-on and knows what's happening? What has relationship? What has the teams? What has everything done for you? Now, lifestyle, it's all set in place. So it's a window. So my whole point here in this long dissertation is the timing is perfect. So whatever you would have to do, I speak to anyone on here tonight who is new or who maybe is sitting here saying, gee, it just doesn't happen the way I want it to happen. And I'm just going to say, it's not a real great managerial team, but suck it up, Buckwheat. I mean, get with the program because you're either going to be in or you're going to be out because this is just starting to happen. What are we, a year and a half old?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Baby. I mean,
we haven't even started crawling good yet.
Nope.
It just isn't happening.
Yeah.
And all these things that are out there dropping all around us. And so all here comes the focus, you know, and the example of the California gold mine. that's really true. That's right on track because we do have all the tools that everybody in this business needs to build their business. So anyway, I'd share just one other quick little thing with you about mindset because it's so important. When I was a sales rep, actually I was the sales manager with the company at this time. I was building a sales force, but I was really the primary person doing the selling here at the time. And the Executone Corporate had a relationship with a little company called Mitsushita in Japan, and they had a little subsidiary called Panasonic. Wow. And Panasonic was manufacturing they were manufacturing all the equipment for Executone. And so I tell you that because Panasonic came out with this sales contest, all right? And for the contest ran for 3 weeks. There were over 3,000 Executone salespeople in the United States. There was going to be one winner. And at the end of that time period, that winner would go to Japan, Taiwan, Hong Kong for 16 days, all expenses paid, and tour the manufacturing facilities and provide input on equipment, et cetera. It was a heck of a deal. To which I just kind of cavalier to the whole thing, saying, yeah, you know, up against Chicago, New York, LA, they'll be sandbagging. And you guys know what sandbagging, right? Whether you get a sales group together and they pool all their resources, so they dump it all into one person who wins the trip, and the rest, and that person pays everybody off with cash, so there's a kind of a win-win. So I didn't pay much attention to it, just doing my thing. And at the end of the first month, the flyer came out from corporate, and I looked at it, and I had difficulty reading, understanding it, because it said I was leading the nation. And I said, this can't be real. I mean, they're out there bagging this thing up. They're just waiting, you know, to do it and so on. So I really kind of, I was kind of cavalier in the whole process. And then I talked to a few people that were probably more advanced in terms of mindset than I was at that particular time.
I doubt it.
And they convinced me that you can do this, you know. I mean, you are leading it, you know, go after it. Mm-hmm. So I made a commitment. I said, okay, I'm going to go after it. So I went and I found all kinds of information about Japan. I had a little geisha girl on my bathroom mirror. I'd talk to her every morning when I was shaved. She had all this ornate Japanese stuff and things like this. And anyway, I'll fast forward and tell you that at the end of the 3 months, I won that contest.
Yeah.
And you got 5 points for an equipment cabinet and 1 point per phone on this one particular system. And little Omaha, Nebraska, and Lincoln and the surrounding area. It was amazing, the support that I got. I just told business people, they said, well, I don't need this thing for like 3 more months. And I said, well, you can, if you sign the contract now and you put a little money down, you got price protection. No matter what happens, you got the price. And I tell them about the contest, and they look at it and say, "We're against the nation." I said, "Yeah, it's Nebraska against the world." And they'd say, "Give me that paper." I swear to you, Nebraska fans sent me on that trip.
That's awesome. Yep, yep. I gotta tell you, our friend Caesar asked you about the little geisha that you had in your bathroom. He asked if she answered back when you talked to her. I'm sorry.
So I don't know. It's important to have that. And I think one other thing I would mention, I have to go back to the phone company before I left for this one. And I did a video on this too, because it really, I love doing true videos.
Yeah.
And this one about the black door is really one that made a big difference. I don't know if you recall that. Maybe I shouldn't even tell it. Maybe everybody's heard
it. No, you should tell it.
Okay. So this is a true happening, because I'm with the phone company for 10 years. I'd hit a point where I didn't feel like I could go anymore. I was getting pretty antsy. And so I decided I was going to, you know, maybe I started looking around. And I looked around and I had some things going on. And I had this thing going on with the Executone here in Omaha, but I hadn't accepted it yet. And so I'm really stewing about that. So, hey, small town, Iowa, I go home for lunch, no big deal. And I get the mail before I go in. I'm standing at the kitchen counter and I'm going through a bunch of mail, you know, junk mail, trash. And a piece of paper, about half of it, 8.5 by 11, a kind of pale blue, fell on the floor, and it was just blank. I picked it up and turned it over, and it said, "The Saga of the Black Door." And I thought, oh, it's short. I'll just read it. Okay, so here you go. Take a little trip with me now. Back to the times of King Arthur and the Round Table, and back in the time we had knights and all this kind of stuff. And back then, there was this very fair and just king. I'm doing a real quick synopsis of it here. And whenever anybody in his kingdom was sentenced to death for a heinous crime or whatever, they were always brought before the king and given a choice. The choice was they could have their punishment carried out, or they could have the fate that lie behind the black door. Mm. And so this one particular day, this fellow was brought before the king, given his choice, and he stood there and he twisted and turned and broke into a sweat. And finally, he took his sentencing. And so they took him outside, and amidst the screams of his execution, one of the little aides or sires or whatever you call them beside the king asked the king if he could ask him a question. And he says, "Sure, what's that?" And he says, "Well, just what is it that's on the other side of that black door?" He says, "Oh, it's quite simple." He says, "It's forgiveness of all crimes and total freedom for the rest of your life." Mm. But he said, "But few are they that will ever venture into the unknown." And with that, I turned in my resignation. I kid you not.
That's awesome.
I'll tell you what, anybody that was blessed enough to hear this tonight live or in the future, you guys, I just want to let you know, if you're just kind of hanging around now lifestyle, you're not really signed up, do you know you can work personally with Donald Leath if you just reach out to him? Mm-hmm. Do you know that he can help you go to the top, because that's where he's going, in the most profound ways?
And where else?
Just leaving that out there.
Like, where else in the internet? I mean, we were in offline network marketing for years, and we've seen other companies. You don't get this type of community. You don't get this type of mindset. Like, there are people, Zig Ziglar, Tony Robbins, Grant Cardone, people that charge thousands of dollars to go and get just this type of mindset that allow for you to go and just be poured into. And you get it every Monday night with this couple right here. And you were blessed enough tonight to have Donald Leath sit here and pour into you like that. This doesn't happen online. Not like this. You get one of those lame pre-recorded webinars and they pitch you something. We're not even going to talk about it. Like, we're just going to help you work on your mind.
Here's what I know. Yeah. Everybody online that's coming online for the first time needs a coach.
Yeah. Oh, for sure.
Needs a coach.
We needed one.
Yeah.
We like.
There's this guy over here. Just saying.
Awesome.
It's pretty special. So, Don, thank you so much for hopping on with us tonight. We're so blessed just to be associated with you. You've helped Ashleigh and I out a ton.
Yes.
With everything you've ever taught us or told us. We're thankful that our relationship is just in the beginning phases, because, man, this thing is going to be fun to build with you.
Well, thank you so much. I feel like I talked an awful lot. I just had
I was hoping you would talk.
We sometimes just like to bring guests on, and we're like, just unleash them.
I have nothing to say, but not as a whole. Make notes.
Yeah. And people are, I mean, comments are blowing up here.
David, you're getting Kilby, about 10 bazillion awesome hearts right now.
Jennifer
which is
Brown
cool.
says you're so insightful. Jerry 3, Elite Team Jerry, this was priceless. Sandy says, I bet Don has many more awesome stories, which is very true.
You guys, not lifestyles, literally just being introduced to Don Elite for the first time. We're so flattered and honored to be the people that introduce them. It's just crazy.
Yeah. So, all right. Are we good?
I really do have to say one final thing.
Yeah.
That if it wasn't for Joel Therien and his openness and his transparency and his honesty, I was done with the online world.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah. And then it filters on down into, you know, the leadership team and everybody else. It's just amazing. It really is.
Man. Well, Don, thanks so much. I mean, I Ashleigh and I will probably say thank you for like the next 100 years, because you're going to live to be very old. And every time we see it, we're so blessed that we honestly, we're blessed that you reached out and said, hey, you know, let's connect. Because if you hadn't done that, I don't know if Ashleigh and I would be here today. You're a pretty special guy.
Well, thanks so much. I really enjoyed it. A lot of fun. And, you know, I always learn something being around you guys and the rest of the 3LE team. So it's awesome.
Good stuff.
He's just being humble. We learn more from him.
That's true.
Every time, and Don has shared a couple of those stories, most of those I've never heard before, but he made me think about being bold. And he's one of the most humble people, which is one of the reasons that Ashleigh and I just fell in love with him and his wife, was they're so humble. They've no reason to be humble, but they are humble because they love people. And I just want to tell you guys a story. And I'm glad that I was this young man when I was probably 19, because if I hadn't been, I don't know that I would have ever been bold enough to meet a Donald Leith. I mean, I had this guy when I was 19 years old in a different business offline. I was dirt poor. I mean, like, I'm talking about ramen noodles were like pretty expensive for me in those days. And I'm serious. And I was just mad about my business to this guy one day. And he was, you know, according to the business we were in, like a big shot or a big wig or a big deal. And I said, I'll just say his name's Nate. And I said, Nate, I can do what you do and I can do it better than you. And this guy's ego was just outside this planet. Probably mine was for even saying that to him, but I was serious. And he said, Adam, you couldn't handle my business. I wish you could live a day in my shoes just so you would shut up. And to this day, I said, Nate, I guarantee you I'd handle it and I'd smoke your butt in your business. And he said, yeah, whatever, I don't believe you, blah, 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 blah. To this day, I guarantee you I'd smoke him in that business. And I'm smoking him today. You know why? Because I got awesome business partners like Donald Leith, and nobody can compete. When two men like Don and I, or like anybody that joins us, when we lock arms, I'm just saying, bring it on. I'm not asking for a fight, but if you want one, you got one, because we are not about to lose in this game, okay? Oh, we're just getting started. We believe in you. We love you. Thanks so much, Don.
Thanks, Don.
Thank you, guys. Thanks, everybody.
You guys
have a good night.